Good morning. Namaskar. To all of you who come today braving the rains, thank you for coming. Thank you for your presence here in India House. And thank you for this opportunity to celebrate together the second International Day of Yoga. One thing that I can say to you, now that you've made the effort, 45 or 50 minutes from now, you will go back feeling that it was really worth the effort. That I'm sure of. So, I'd like to explain a little bit about the International Day of Yoga. In 2014, our Prime Minister, Shri Narendra Modi, moved a proposal to the United Nations General Assembly proposing that we, the UN, celebrate the 21st of June every year as the International Day of Yoga. The resolution was passed in December 2014 with an enormous majority, and from then on, the 21st of June is celebrated worldwide as the International Day of Yoga. Last year, in June, we celebrated it for the first time, and millions and millions of people from all over the world in their own countries took part in the group practice sessions of yoga, one of which we will be doing today. On the same day, all over the world, we practiced the same set of yogic asanas or poses. This year, we are doing the same, and we are doing it on days as close to the 21st of June as possible, which is convenient for everyone. So, what we will practice today will be the common yoga protocol. This is a set of asanas which has been designed by some of the most eminent yoga experts in India, and it is meant to provide an initiation into yoga to all of us today. There will be simple poses which can be practiced by anyone, but they will give you a certain sense of what it is. We will also do a little bit of pranayama or breathing exercises, and right in the end, a short, very short initiation into meditation or dhyan. There are many misconceptions or fixed notions about yoga. Sometimes we hear phrases such as hot yoga or power yoga, which appear to focus very strongly on the physical aspects of it. At other times, others try to make it seem like something very esoteric, something very mystifying. I think the aim of the common yoga protocol and the aim of the Prime Minister, the government, is really to explain that yoga is for everyone. Yoga has something in it for everyone. And what is it mainly? It is a united, yoga itself means, as we will see in this short film, to unite. It comes from the Sanskrit word to unite or to integrate. So yoga is a holistic system of wellness, a way of life which seeks to unite physical and mental well-being. That's all it is really. So we present yoga as a way to make your self, your physical self, stronger. We believe that yoga prevents disease, the regular practice of yoga prevents disease. It's also something that will calm and focus your mind. It is something that can serve to de-stress you, to remove tension from your life. And above all, I think, to make you a better version of yourself and to promote your existing in harmony with your natural environment. That's really the very simple message of yoga, and that's what we want, that's the message we want everyone to go away with today. Today's program, we will show you a short film in which our Prime Minister and our External Affairs Minister's message on this day will be relayed to you. They'll show you a little bit of the practice with some of the group sessions of yoga last year. And after that, I will leave you in the hands of our very capable yoga expert, Sri Brahmanand. Sri Brahmanand lives in Brunei, in Belai, since many years now. We are lucky to have him here. He's a very good, very renowned yoga expert. He will take us through the steps of the common yoga protocol. And after that, we will just have just a few. You can pick up a small box of refreshments on your way out and a booklet on the common yoga protocol. Our intention is when you go home and in the time to come, if you like, you can redo the steps of what we do today at home with this booklet. It has sketches and diagrams and it takes you through the steps again of the very introductory yogic asanas that we will do today. Thereafter, if any of you want to be part of a regular program of yoga, you can be in touch with us and we will put you in touch with the places in the capital and Belai where regular yoga classes are offered. So to all of you, once again, I say welcome, you're very welcome, and I wish you a very happy and peaceful practice of yoga today. Namaskar.
ऐसा लग रहा है कि पहला अंतर्राष्ट्रीय योगा दिवस जैसे अभी अभी ही गया है, क्योंकि योगा के प्रति जो उमंग और उत्साह का माहौल बना है, पूरा विश्व एक योगा कम्युनिटी के रूप में परिवर्तित हो गया है। पूरी धरती माता जैसे योगा के लिए एक प्लेटफॉर्म बन गई है और व्यक्ति की समष्टि तक की यात्रा का एक आधार बन गई है। अब लोग योगा को सिर्फ आरोग्य नहीं, एक वेलनेस के लिए महत्वपूर्ण जीवन का अंग मानने लगे हैं। आज जब हम दूसरे अंतर्राष्ट्रीय योगा पर्व को मनाने जा रहे हैं, तब मेरी विश्व भर के योगा प्रेमियों को बहुत बहुत शुभकामनाएं हैं और मुझे विश्वास है कि पूरा विश्व इस योगा आंदोलन के साथ जुड़ता चला जाएगा, वेलनेस की ओर आगे बढ़ता चला जाएगा और व्यक्ति और समष्टि का योग मिलन सुनिश्चित हो जाएगा।
योग केवल व्यायाम नहीं है, योग एक तनावग्रस्त व्यक्ति का तनाव वापस लेता है, दूर करके उसे तनाव रहित बनाता है। योग अशांत मन को शांत करता है, इसलिए आइए हम सब योग को अपनाएं, अपना मन भी शांत करें और विश्व शांति के मार्ग पर आगे बढ़ें।
योग भारत की सांस्कृतिक विरासत है। आज योग पूरे विश्व में फैल रहा है और इसके विस्तार के पीछे अनेक योग गुरुओं का योगदान रहा है। योग के द्वारा पूरे विश्व में लोग आरोग्यवर्धक और रोग निदान का लाभ उठा रहे हैं। विश्व योग दिवस के सफल आयोजन हेतु मेरी शुभकामनाएं।
The Prime Minister, Mr. Narendra Modi, led the yoga demonstration organized by the Ministry of Ayush, Government of India, at Rajpath in New Delhi, as the world celebrated the first International Day of Yoga on June 21st, 2015, with full enthusiasm. On this momentous occasion, two Guinness World Records were made, namely, the largest yoga lesson involving 35,985 participants and the maximum number of nationalities, 84, that participated in a single yoga session. Billions of people participated with full enthusiasm in this first International Day of Yoga celebrations across the globe. Yoga is essentially a spiritual discipline based on extremely subtle science. It is an art and science for healthy living. The word yoga is derived from the Sanskrit word yug, meaning to join or unite. According to yogic scriptures, the practice of yoga leads to the union of the individual consciousness with that of the universal consciousness, indicating a perfect balance between mind and body, man and nature.
My name is Brahma, and I'm so pleased to be instructed today, and I'm also thankful to Indian High Com for organizing such a beautiful function and giving us such a place, shared place to have such a good morning. And I hope all of us together will experience something which is in the protocol, but it will be a memorable experience for all of us. And as I think, I'm so blessed, I think all of us are so blessed to have a Sunday morning like this and having all our friends and family together and performing yoga. What else you need on Sunday morning? And talking about health, doing yoga is an ultimate experience. And we just begin with three breaths today, and we see how it changes our morning. And as I count, we go three times. I just say breathe in and relax and release. One more time. Relax and release. One more time. Relax and release. So we are getting ready. So I just said, yoga is also wisdom. In general, we think that the body and mind are two separate things. But in reality, body, mind and breath are integrated systems. They're part of the same. Because the body is the cross product of the mind, and mind is subtle product of the body. So what yoga does, yoga harmonizes and integrates body, mind and breath. So what we are practicing today, harmonizing all three components together. So this journey for next 1 hour, we'll try that how we'll sync breath, body and mind all together and experience the yoga, which is uniting all of them, as Madam said. We are uniting all three components and aligning it throughout the 1 hour. And that experience you can carry. So to begin, as I say, you have to rise with me, because all posture we will start with the standing posture. So I will request you to all rise with me. So that's why if you keep your neck healthy, you're actually achieving most of your health. So let's begin with the stretching of our neck. So focus on the breath when I say how to follow breath. So as I said, three components we are aligning. So today, keep your focus in three components. Your body, your mind, and your breath. So let's say, my all instruction will have breath instruction inbuilt into it. So you have to follow breath with me. So keep in a samasthiti, which is tadasana, very simple, straight and relaxed posture. And when we'll bend our neck backward and forward, first we'll go forward while breathing out.
Touch your chin
to your chest.
Slowly
breathe in and go back. Go further back, go further back, go whatever extent you can stretch and relax. Come back. Again, breathe out. Try your neck to touch your chest. Again, slowly. While breathing in, go up to the back. Again, breathe out. Slowly come forward. Try to touch your chin to chest. Again, one more time. Back, stretch and slowly come down the center. Keep your hand sides. Now we'll go second posture, which is right to left. So we'll go right first, again. Breathe in and breathe out. Again, next side, straight. You're trying to touch your ears to your shoulder. Stretch. Come up. the second side. Stretch. Come on. One more time. Stretch. Go straight. Go soft, gentle. Stretch. Straight. Now we'll move to left and right twisting. You have to keep your shoulder straight. When you turn, you don't have to turn your shoulder. You'll turn only your head. So we'll go right first. You just keep your body straight and go right while exhaling. And come back while inhaling. Straight, then exhale and turn to your left. Stretch whatever you can do. Come back. Again, go to the other side. Soft and gentle. Breathe out. Exhale and turn. Come back. One more time. Come to center and go to the left. Go straight. Now, neck rotation. So we'll go take our chin to the chest. While breathing out, then you rotate, go back while breathing in. As you go back out, then you start breathing out when you're coming back to your chest. Yes. Then reverse. Go back while breathing in. And while breathing out, you come back to your chest, your chin to your chest. Again, rotate. Go back, breathing in. Breathe out and come back. One more time. Breathe in, go back, breathe out, come back. Now straight. Now we'll go with the shoulder. We are the neck, we are moving to shoulders. Shoulder is, we'll keep very simple, keep your feet 2 inches apart. Keep samasthiti position, again straight posture, which is tadasana. And then we'll just stretch, go up. Keeping hands, yes, just move around. Don't touch your ears. Straight hand up. Then slowly come down and don't touch your thighs. Keep away from thigh. Again, slowly go up while breathing in. Straight and breathe out. It's all about breathing. Again, breathe in. Straight, breathe out. We'll take one more. Breathe in. Breathe out. Now, another very important for shoulder is you have frozen shoulder problems. So you go straight, bend your elbows, put your fingers in your shoulder joint, softly grip them. Softly grip them. You bring it forward, touch them. And rub your ears when you go up and bring down, rubbing your ribs. And again, touch back. Again, go rub your ears, rub your ribs, and touch back. Rub your ears, ribs, and touch back. Clear. We're reverse. Go back. Again, touch your ears. Go back and rub your ribs. Go up. Touch from there. Come back. Again. Third time and relax. Shoulder now west. So we're going one by one body parts. This is simple. Just maybe 1 foot away. You go straight. Keep straight. Now we'll twist slowly our body without turning our waist too much. You just turn slowly. Just turn any side, you take any side. And try to touch this hand to other hand and look back. Again, start turning, turning back, come to the center. Now exhale and go. Then inhale and come back. Again, exhale and turn. Inhale and come back. Exhale and turn. Try to touch your hands. inhale and come back. One more time. You exhale and you twist and touch. Turn, inhaling, again exhale and turn. Inhale and come back. Relax. Go to Samaskrit. Very simple, relaxed posture. We have to rest. Now we go to knees. So knees is, you have to just breathe in, go up, and now exhale and bend, squatting. Keep straight your thigh as well as your hand parallel, then come up, inhale. Exhale, inhale. Exhale, I can see the sink of breath, inhale. One more time then, exhale, and inhale, and just relax. So these are the standing posture, which is only for stretching you up. Now, after this, we'll have an asana. Asana is all well designed and well